Not far from here, just east, a number of miles, is the town of North Platte, Nebraska. Anybody know North Platte, Nebraska? You've been there. North Platte's out there. It's, you know, you got to want to go to North Platte. In 1941, it was a town of 12,000 people. When the Japanese attacked Pearl Harbor on December 7th, 12,000 people at this Union Pacific Railroad hub called North Platte. 10 days later, there was a train coming through with National Guard troops. The word went out it was Nebraska National Guard troops, and so some folks baked cookies and stuff and went down to the train. And they went down to give them some cookies, but they looked in the windows, and it wasn't Nebraska guys. They couldn't find any of their own. It turned out to be Kansas. But they stood there, you know, with the cookies and the cakes and stuff, and finally one young woman by the name of Ray Wilson, a drugstore clerk, said, "Well, I'm not keeping my cookies. I'm not taking my cookies home." She stepped up and gave them to one of the young men, and then everybody gave their stuff. Immediately after that, when they started moving army troops through and sailors and stuff, Ray Wilson organized some women, and they decided they were going to meet the trains that came through North Platte, Nebraska. Bob Green, a journalist from Chicago Tribune, has written about this in a book called Once Upon a Time. And they started to meet the trains, and over the next 4.5 years, they organized mostly women, 55,000 women, and they met every train that came in, sometimes up to 32 trains a day. And the Union Pacific Railway gave the restaurant to them, and they dubbed it the North Platte Canteen, and they got 10 minutes to get off the train. These guys would jump off the train, run in there, and there would be wall-to-wall tables with sandwiches and cakes and pies. One woman said, "My job during the war was to make 10 angel food cakes from scratch with turkey eggs every week in the back of that train station." Everything was rationed. People had to give it out of their own goods. Only $5 came from the government, and it was a check from Franklin Roosevelt. Said, "I heard you're doing some good things out there," and he sent $5. The people of these towns like yours, all over that area, came there. During the course of the war, I mean, these guys would jump out of the train, run in there, and there'd be hot coffee, there'd be donuts, there'd be pheasant sandwiches in season. And I said this at the Nebraska governor's prayer breakfast, and the senator came to me afterwards and said, "Sometimes pheasant sandwiches out of season." And they'd get back on the train, and they'd go off, many never to return. During the course of the war, 6 million United States servicemen and women came through North Platte, Nebraska, and every single train was met. And the story would go something like this. A guy would say, "I graduated from Brooklyn High School, never been out of New York City, went down and signed up on Monday. They put me on a train going west. I rode for 3 days a night, sitting up, eating K rations, not taking a shower, and somebody in the middle of the night said, 'North Platte, Nebraska, next stop.' Never heard of North Platte, Nebraska. Jumped off the train, ran into a place, and I saw girls who looked like my sisters and my cousins, and women who looked like my aunts and my mom. And they had all this food, and they gave it to us. And when we left, they hugged us, and they said, 'Sailor, we're praying for you. God bless you.' And we get back on the train, scared out of our minds, not knowing where we were going, not knowing if we'd ever come back. But when we went into that place for 10 minutes, something went away. We got back on the train and we went on. And in the middle of the night in France, with mortars coming down, when there was a lull in the fighting, a voice would come out of the darkness saying, 'Wouldn't it be great to be back in North Platte for 5 minutes?' Because love chases away fear." And when Bob Green interviewed these guys, they'd start crying. 85-year-old guys start crying. He said, "What are you crying for?" He said, "Because here I was, an 18-year-old kid, scared to death. And I went into that place, and for 5 minutes in the middle of the night, in a place I'd never been to with people I'd never met, going to a place I didn't know, somebody loved me and was kind to me." I told this story in Denver a couple years ago at the 60th anniversary of Youth for Christ Campus Life. A young woman came up to me the next morning and said, "When you were telling that story, I thought about my grandpa. My grandpa was in the Navy, and he lived in Pennsylvania, and I wondered, did he go through North Platte, Nebraska?" She said, "My grandpa's 90 years old in a nursing home, and he has dementia. He doesn't remember us most of the time. But I called him and I said, Grandpa, this is Jennifer. And I said, Grandpa, does the name North Platte, Nebraska mean anything to you? And he said, North Platte, Nebraska. Instantly, he was lucid. You bet it does. He said, I went in there and they gave me donuts and sandwiches and coffee and they shined my shoes. You bet I remember North Platte, Nebraska. What is it, 60 years after the fact, that brings a 90-year-old man out of dementia? When you're scared and you're 18 and you're going off to war, and on the way, somebody loves you and is kind to you.
America's military services, facing the awesome effects of yet another war, are being deployed even as this video plays. Resources, however, are available to encourage these men, women, and their families in much the same way as the North Platte Canteen marked its historical place in serving our nation's military. These men and women of the armed forces will step upon treacherous soil that will leave them with questionable futures as to their welfare and their return to home and family. But military ministry, just like North Platte, is there to give them the encouragement, love, and support in the difficult times ahead.